Gareth Southgate has released his final provisional 33-man squad for England's Euro 2024, and seven of those names will be dropped. And we'll discuss the seven that I would drop in a second, who I think was unlucky not to be called out, because no Harvey Elliott. I think he was probably most unlucky not to be called up for the provisional squad. Southgate could have at least said, look, I'm thinking of you. Sancho wasn't called up. Obviously, Ben White wasn't called up. No Colwill, he might be a bit disappointed. Chilwell, Rashford and Sterling were dropped, but Grealish was still picked, which, to be honest, I would have rather had Rashford than Grealish, although they wouldn't make my final 23. Liveramento, Lewis Hall were maybe hoping for something at fullback with Luke Shaw's injuries and Chilwell being dropped. They weren't picked. Elise is eligible to play for England, but I think he wants to play for France. Otherwise, I'd have picked Elise. Angel Gomez may feel a bit unlucky he wasn't picked. He's had a very good season. Rico Lewis has had a decent season. So, yeah, there's a lot of names out there that might feel a little bit unlucky to be dropped. But let me actually go up and get Southgate squad up on my screen. I've sort of split it up into sections here for you guys, and what we're going to do is we're going to go through each section and I'm going to highlight the seven players I would drop as we go through each section, and I give you guys my opinion on the squad. Now there's a couple new names in there. Kwanzaa, well done, he's done very well. Obviously Curtis Jones, first call up, he's done very well, and I think England need more profiles like Curtis Jones, midfielders that can keep the ball. Adam Wharton's called up, very, very well deserved as well. There's a couple maybe more surprise names in there as well, but we're going to go through each position and I'm going to tell you who I dropped. Now, starting with goalkeeper, don't really need to explain that, but Trafford is overrated. Look, Nick Pope, if he hadn't just come back from injury, would easily be there in there over Trafford. If Johnston wasn't injured, he'd be in there over Trafford. I mean, Burnley have realised they're better without him. He's just sort of got that Man City overrated tax from being a good kid. But the League One to Premier League step up, you know, I feel sorry for him, but my main three would be Pickford, Ramsdale, Henderson. I think had Pope not been injured, he'd have been in there because Ramsdale's not playing. Henderson's very well lately because Johnston's injured. So no doubt about the goalkeepers. Pickford will be number one, and he's had a good season at Everton. I know a lot of people aren't a big fan of Pickford, but for England, he's good and he's had a good season for Everton. So don't think you can argue that. At fullback, I've put Gomez in as fullback, which he is actually probably written down as a centre-back. Is that written down? Is that a word? Or wrote down? Wrote down as a centre-back, my English there. But he can play left-back, he can play right-back, he can play centre-back. And for that case, Gomez will not be dropped. Actually, I'm not going to drop anyone on this list because realistically, we don't know how fit Luke Shaw is. I think Luke Shaw being picked, even though he hasn't played since January, is a risk from Southgate. But there's no doubt in my mind, Luke Shaw is England's best left-back. I'd like to see a Lewis Hall, a Liveramento, who's more of a right-back, be given a chance in the future. But there's no doubt in my mind that Luke Shaw is England's best left-back. He was England's arguably best player at Euro 2024. And he has fitness issues, but when he's fit, he's good. Like, so I get taking the risk on Luke Shaw because he will start. No Reece James, but he hasn't played basically at all this season, whereas Luke Shaw has played elements of this season and should be back and ready for the Euros. Kyle Walker being picked for experience. Trent has been wrote down as a midfielder, but I've put Trent in fullback there. But I think Southgate will probably play him in midfield if he does play him. Obviously, Trippier. People have questions over Trippier. Had a very good start to the season at Newcastle. Was up for player of the season at the first 3 months of the season. But yeah, Trippier's massively dropped off. But with Luke Shaw's fitness questions, he can play left back, he can play right back. He has been good for England international tournaments. Maguire has actually had a very good season for United when he's played, but he hasn't played much because he's had injury issues. And John Stones is a very good player who's had injury issues as well. But I think there's no arguments that Stones and Maguire are England centre-back pairing. I think there is a few question marks over Maguire because he's not played as much lately. But I think there's not someone that's like a standout name. Potentially Kwanzaa or Branthwaite in the future, but are they ready to? I don't know. So yeah, that's fair. Gay, I'm very happy Gay's been called up. I really like that Southgate's looked at Crystal Palace players, because one thing Southgate has done is that favouritism towards the top six, the big six sides. I like that he's looking at Branthwaite. I like that he's looking at Gay and Anthony Gordon. I like it because I actually did a tweet back in, I'm going to say like January, and I said, I want to see Gordon and Branthwaite called up for England, two names out of the top six. And I said Curtis Jones could be main as my other two names, which all four have been called up now. So Southgate listened to my tweet, hey, probably didn't, but you know what I mean. Kwanzaa, well-deserved call up. He's been very, very good for Liverpool these final games of the season. I think it's definitely a good player in Kwanzaa. Dunk, solid player, does a job, got a bit of experience. Kwanzaa, what a season he's had with Villa, can play right back, can play centre back, versatility there. Branthwaite, young, brilliant. We're gonna have to drop one of these names, and I'm gonna drop Dunk. I'm going to go back and drop other names. I think we've got to drop 7 names to take it from 33 to 26, if my math is correct. I filmed a TikTok saying I had to drop like 10 names. And then I remembered, because I was being a bit idiotic, that actually, no, it's 26 names you take, not 23. So this is actually the second time I recorded this video, because for some reason I thought it was 23 names, not 26. So maybe you could bring, you know, certain players for the experience, like, because it's 26 now, not 23, because a lot of players aren't gonna have much to do. You can argue that, but I would take Dunk. I'm obviously going to remove more names off this list later on, but we're just doing one from each position. But I'm not going to remove any of the fullbacks, because I think while some people were slating Joe Gomez being picked, which I think is crazy, he's been good for Liverpool this season. He can play left back, he can play right back, he can play center back, he's such a versatile asset, and he's you know, had experience playing for England before. I wouldn't drop any of the fullbacks because of the fitness issues. Midfield, I really like. Rice, Maino, Jones, Gallagher, Wharton. I'm a big fan of Wharton. I'm a big fan of Cobbie Maino. And I said I'd like to see Curtis Jones called up for England. What England lack is players that can retain the ball. And you've got that in Maino and Jones. You've got workhorses across England. You've got Rice, that's your destroyer DM. You've got Bellingham, that is going to play an attacking midfield. But that position between Rice and Bellingham has been up for grabs. And I think there was a lot of people angry that Maino was picked and not Harvey Elliott. But Harvey Elliott will be picked as an attacking midfielder, not a defensive midfield option. You can't compare Harvey Elliott to Wharton or Maino or Jones. I know he can play deeper, but you can't. And I think that's why Wharton's been called up and not Harvey Elliott, because there's less competition. I would have put Harvey Elliott in attacking midfield options, even if he doesn't make the final 23, just to say, hey, I'm thinking about you. You've had a very good end to the season at Liverpool. You deserve to be here. And I think Harvey Elliott is probably the most unlucky name to miss out. But I am really glad that Wharton was called up. People are going to disagree with me on this, but the first name I drop for midfield is Gallagher. And you'll be saying, Alice, you're crazy, you're mad. Gallagher's had a pretty good season for Chelsea. He's a workhorse. Him and Casado work well together. The reason I drop him is I'm thinking of the profile of midfielder you want between Rice and Bellingham. Gallagher's a workhorse. I want someone that can take care of the ball. Might be crazy saying Maino and Jones over Gallagher, but Maino and Jones take care of the ball better. Wharton is more of a backup for Rice. Gallagher can't play Rice's position, whereas Maino and Wharton can. So it's a toss-up between Gallagher and Jones for that middle position. And I think Curtis Jones suits more what England need. It will be Jones that's dropped than Gallagher that's taken, which is fair. He's a workhorse. And if you think of mentality, players you want in the squad, fair enough bringing in Gallagher. But he's actually who I take out, which some people will probably argue, you silly idiot, which is fair enough as well. Which brings me into the attacking midfield position. Maddison is called up, which is fair. I know Maddison's had a pretty stinky end to the season, but he was on fire at the beginning of the season. We know his quality. Bellingham's an obvious one. Do I need to explain that? Eze, I'm glad he's called up. Very, very good player. Eze has been in better form than Maddison. So part of me thinks, do you drop Maddison and take Eze? But then I think Eze can play a bit. They can both play out wide, but Eze is better out wide. It's a difficult one. But I'm thinking potentially England experience. I would probably drop Eze, but I am a big fan of Eze. I would love to take Eze. Which brings us into the wingers. Saka, Palmer, Foden, Gordon. All four have had amazing seasons. Bowen's had an amazing season. You've got 5 wingers that have had amazing season in Grealish. Now, to be honest with you, I would have had Rashford instead of Grealish in my provisional squad, but he wouldn't have made my final 26. As much as I'd like to put Rashford in my final 26, I don't think he deserves it because of how bad he's been this season. But Rashford is better for England than Grealish. Rashford has the worst PR on social media at the moment. Everyone on social media thinks he's much worse than he is, and he's the most hated player on social media. Rashford has had a bad season. He's been poor this season. And he does not deserve to be in the England squad because Anthony Gordon, Foden, Palmer, Saka and Bowen have been a lot better. But when you look at what England need, Grealish is very similar to sort of the Foden, Palmer kind of profile of player that we've also got in Eze and Maddison. Rashford is very different. Rashford can basically do what Son did when Son played with Kane. He's that kind of pace and power type winger that's got good output. There's almost like an inside forward that's got the pace, that's lethal on transition. And we know that Son and Kane are such a good partner pairing. We know that Rashford and Kane work really well together. We know that because Rashford was really good at the World Cup. He came off the bench. I think he was our top goal scorer or something. Or not top goal scorer, but he scored some really good games off the bench. When he came on, on versus France, he was the most threatening player. Like, yes, he's had a bad season, but he was good for England in international tournaments. He can change games for England. He's someone that you wouldn't start, but it's an option to come off the bench. I think Rashford has way more impact than Grealish. So I'd have taken Rashford over Grealish. I can't argue about Rashford not being there, to be honest, because he's been bad this season and maybe it'll give him a kick up the bum. But I think his season's been as poor as Grealish. He's got 3 goals this season. Rashford is more what England need than Grealish. Profile-wise, he's been better for England than Grealish. And he offers something different. Now, Anthony Gordon is a player I massively rate, and he's the only out-and-out left-winger for me, which is another reason why I preferred Rashford to Grealish, because he's the most similar to Gordon stylistic. If Gordon has a good Euros and steps up and becomes England's left-winger for the Euros, he can do that role that Rashford did, for sure. And I'm confident that Gordon can do that. Because of that, the first name I'm going to drop in the wing is Grealish, doesn't deserve to be there. And the second name I'm going to drop is Bowen. And I feel horrible dropping Bowen because he's had a brilliant season and he deserves to be called up. But you've got to think Saka and Palmer. You need 2 left-wingers, 2 right-wingers. Saka and Palmer can play on the right. Foden can even play on the right. Gordon's the only out-and-out left-winger there. So, you know, and Gordon and Bowen have both had amazing seasons, but I'm a massive fan of Anthony Gordon. I really like his work rate. He's a workhorse. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 players that have been dropped so far. We need to drop, I believe, 1 more player. Is it just 1 more player being dropped? Because we can take 26. I think it's 1 more player that needs to be dropped. 7, 33 minus 7. Yes, only 1 more player needs to be dropped. So we're going to the strikers. Kane, Watkins, Tony. Harry Kane, do we even need to speak about that? Best striker in the world. Watkins got the most goal contributions in the Premier League this season, or second most over after Palmer, one of the two. Tony is a better player than Watkins in all-round play, hold-up play, link-up play. If you're not creating chances, Tony's off-the-ball work is better. But Watkins had a better season than Tony. Tony hasn't scored in the last 10, 12 games. He's fallen off a bit, hasn't been in the best form. So for that reason, I dropped Tony. And this would be my final squad. Now, it was a toss-up between Dunk and Kwanzaa over who I dropped, but I'm trying to think of the future. I like this young squad for them to get experience. Maybe it's probably mean dropping Gallagher. To be honest, part of me wants to do this, to be honest, because I only need to drop 6 names. I think it is mean dropping Gallagher because he's got that captain mentality. Maybe I should do that. Maybe that will be the 6th I drop. Maybe I'll change 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I've got to drop 7 names. Maybe I take Gallagher and maybe I go Kwanzaa. I'm thinking of you. You deserve to be in the squad, but you know, you're going to get your chance next time. Just a few more games. Maybe I'll do that. I do think Harvey Elliott was really unlucky to miss out. I would have picked Rashford over Grealish, but I can't argue that much more, can I? Rashford's been bad. I think Chilwell, yeah, fair enough. Sterling, fair enough, dropped. I think Colwill might have been a bit unlucky. I do really like Colwill. Lewis Hall, you could argue, is a bit unlucky. Rico Lewis, Angel Gomez, Liveramento, maybe. Anyway, let me know your thoughts down below. Let me know who you dropped and let me know who you think was unlucky not to be called up. Thank you for watching. Bye.